Around the base. This is really strong stuff, so I want to use it sparingly. So, mix a combination. Thank you. coming in here again with that purple and blue mixture. Just kind of even things out where they need to be. So I think I'm going to let that set up, probably overnight. So I can see what I've got when it's dry, and now I understand it's going to be a little shiny from the standpoint of my medium's not done drying by tomorrow. But if I can look past that, I can see if I've shaded this the way it should be. With a million strokes. Next order of business. Putting away my pointy there we go. Then I'm going to start outlining all my whites with my dark brown. Just to make them, to clean them up a little bit, and to make them pop. is my opportunity to shade, change the shape, clean up the shape. Mostly it's clean up. But I will be coming back once more with the white on the third pass. It should further clean things up. It's kind of this concept of the lightest light next to the darkest dark. Really does make for better contrast and a crisper, cleaner look. If you look closely at the real life feathers, you'll see that's how it really is. There's a dark area right next to the lightest area. Go down the center, the back here, and cleaning these things up. And I'm starting on the little ones because they're always the most difficult. I try to get the most difficult job out of the way first. Some of these cases, they're a little sloppy, so they look like they're just splotches. Mother Nature isn't that messy. Sometimes it's just a matter of touching the brush right next to that spot in one place to change or soften its look. the feathers get bigger, it gets easier for me to. Paint, as always. I'm coming back and cleaning up a little bit of my overpainting onto the whites. It's almost impossible to avoid. But if you notice it right away, it'll save you time and maybe even an extra coat of paint if you clean up as you go. So, take a break here. Take my mom out to lunch, and I'll be back. It may take some going back and forth to with carbon black or dark brown to offset the shine that's happening here, but we're going to give it some time to dry. You can be really surprised sometimes when you think it's going to be shiny and you come back and it actually is matte. So that's what I'm going to do now. See you next time.